Here we are, we've got our excavation going on here, the Holme Fen Spitfire. So this plane came down in November 1940, and we have taken the opportunity to conduct this excavation before this whole area becomes new wetland habitat. It's part of a wider scheme called Rhymes Reedbed, 140 hectares, just north of the track there. And we're gradually raising the water table over 5 years to create a mosaic of different wetland habitats. So it's the 75th anniversary of the Battle of Britain, and it seemed a good opportunity to get the Spitfire out before the ground became too wet and too difficult.
Almost 75 years ago, 22nd of November 1940, Harold Penketh and two other pilots took off in a trio of Spitfires from RAF Wittering to conduct combat training in, above here. So unfortunately that day, when Penketh was climbing to about 2,000 feet, he lost control of his aircraft. The theory is probably to do with a failure in the oxygen system, and the plane plummeted to the ground. It sort of tried to right itself, it failed, and literally hit the ground at over 300 miles an hour, where we have now been excavating our large hole here. And then that location and knowledge of that crash has always been known locally and on the records that the military keep. Indeed, we even had two local farmers who actually witnessed it. They were popped out here yesterday, gave some of their recollections of what happened on that day. And then we sort of come forward 75 years forward to today, and we're here looking for it to recover it before it becomes sort of lost to us, I suppose, with the re-wetting and the Great Fen project, which sort of is the sort of, I suppose, the trigger as to why we're here, and it makes it very exciting for us to have the opportunity. Not only are we obviously uncovering the remains of the Spitfire that's coming up, but actually we're getting the sort of story of the absolute Herculean effort that the RAF recovery team went to in 1940 to get Harold Penketh out. And I think this has surprised everybody, not least of all some of the aviation people who are used to this. They don't really ever encounter or expect that sort of effort. So what we've been finding here is that that's a huge hole, bigger than the Spitfire would have created itself, because they came here and they dug him out. And the records were they spent 7 days here digging. And right to the bottom of the hole where you see at the moment, we're getting woody planks and shorey. And they went right down themselves. Now we're doing it with a machine, they did it all by hand. They came out here, they hand dug the whole thing. And they went right down, recovering him here. And so, they went to a huge effort to get him out. And that actually is something that needs to be reckoned.
Yes, there was.
And then down here, I think I've got part of the microphone, which is there, because that was the other end of this front there. It would have been just here on the side of his face. So I'm trying to get as much mud off as I can. Trying to get the bits that aren't crumbling away, those will go in the water, get as much fuel off as I can. It won't be like get the mud off, it'll literally be just try and get the fuel off, and then they're going to bag it up and get it to conserves as soon as we can.
But this will be more wet grassland than reed bed. So the other side of the road, it's open more to reed bed.
Because you dug scrapes there, is that right?
Well, we've done more than that. There's five big pools over there. There's a whole series of ditches, profile ditches. There's a series of scrapes and hollows. And the reed is already self-propagating, and wildlife, there's already so much wildlife. We had a great buzzard up here last winter.
Fantastic.
Woody crows, great grey shrike.
So 10 years' time, this will be sort of wet grassland?
Yes, seasonally wet grassland.
Yeah, okay, covered in widgeon and waders.
Hopefully, breeding waders.
That tail godwit,
well, that's, that would be our, yeah. So we're not engineering for a particular species.
No. Yeah, just a mosaic of wet. So I've had a great day at the Great Fen today. I've ticked it off my bucket list, and what I've noticed is this is about when area teams take a long-term view of what we want to do with our partners and our customers. So we've invested in our relationships with internal drainage boards, with the Wildlife Trust and with the local farmers, and we're achieving great things together. It might take another 50 years, but I'm confident that with our partners we'll deliver the Great Fen vision. It's been a great day. Thanks.